unconstitutional. What they do in there is everything by the book. Masks, everything, social distances, everything. And to shut them down by selective enforcement by this governor and this mayor, okay, is dangerous. It's very dangerous to this country. So that's...
Well, we're standing out here to show solidarity, and I we want the governor to understand that we on Staten Island, you know, don't roll over lightly, and we will not bow down to somebody who is going to be ambiguous with the rules. You know, the funny thing about this whole thing is that while the governor and the mayor have made decisions about closing businesses down and taking people's livelihoods away, each one of them have received their paycheck every 2 weeks and they've cashed it. So COVID doesn't hit them like it hits the rest of us. They don't have to worry about how to make ends meet because our tax dollars are paying their salary, and not one of them have given up their salary, not once during COVID.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Do you want to speak to, this is Scott Lobato. He's got a lot to say.
Max, let's get a whole bunch of people in front of the TV camera. Everybody over here, hands off. Max Public House now. Hands off. Max Public House now. Hands off. Follow me, camera. Over to the people. You want to see, we got a whole crew here, right? Not just me. Hands off. Max Public House now. Killer Cuomo. Hands off, Staten Island. Killer Cuomo. Hands off, Staten Island. Cuomo, Cuomo, Cuomo. Ireland, you go Irish rebel, go. Go Irish rebel, go. But not just.
Who makes that line? Who puts the line down the street? What is that? That's not America. How do you selective enforcement? You shut everybody down all across the country, or you don't. You don't selective enforce. You have all of these big box businesses that are wide open, making billions of dollars, and these people, if they don't survive, they're gonna go to ugly extremes, and that's what's gonna happen. It's gonna be worse than the virus itself, and this is the perfect example for them to drag this kid out, okay, and give his bartender, a 20-year-old girl, 20-something-year-old girl, a $5,000 fine when she's just trying to feed her family. It's disgusting, and we're not gonna stand for it.
So what are you guys trying to accomplish out here?
Showing solidarity to the owner that made that decision to say he's not going to take the baloney, the garbage lies, okay, and hypocritical double standard, like Chuck Schumer when Biden won the election. He's out without his mask on in public, okay, and these California authorities, okay, everybody, it's do as they say, not as they do. How do you expect people to listen and abide by the rules when you don't abide by them?